Boom! Hey, what's poppin'? My name is Brennan Myers and welcome to another video. In today's video, we're gonna be talking about the middle back. I want you to walk away knowing how to build lean muscle tissue around that area and also two, to feel stronger in your entire back because you're working the right area. So, without further ado, let's jump right in. So, middle back, what is it? How do you get it? How do you build lean muscle tissue in that area? How do you get stronger in that area? There's gonna be a couple things that you're gonna have to be aware of, but first you gotta understand the anatomy, physiology of that positioning or whatever you think your middle back is. So your middle back is really your lower trap. It's that area, okay? And many of us don't even realize, and I didn't realize this for the longest time in my life, that there's three muscles that encompass the trap, right? Like three different areas of it. So you have the upper trap, you have the middle trap, and then you have the lower trap. All of us, we know about the upper traps, right? We get that. But when it comes to bodyweight training, especially, understanding this stuff is extremely, extremely important because you're limited with the movements that you can do. But don't worry, if you're a gym goer, I'm gonna also talk about that as well. So the anatomy and physiology, understand that. That part's very, very important. So those low traps, that's what we're really gonna be focusing on in this video. Low traps, the way they insert, the origin and insertion, their actions of the scaps themselves, anything that is upward rotation, and then anything that is depression, okay? So if you ever see a pronated face pull, so here, and you're coming down, that's depression. Your scaps are coming depressed. Obviously, you're going in downward rotation as well. We don't have to get into that. Obviously, your lats are gonna have like a full effect on those and a lot of different, I'm not even gonna get into it. But you have to keep yourself aware of these actions so that you can work that muscle even more. So anything that's upward rotation, so boom, and then anything that is depression, okay? So what I'm gonna do is give you a few different exercises. I'm gonna pop up the first one here on this screen. So this is a weighted movement, okay? But it's good for you to understand because you're in a specific position. So you have the incline bench and you have some dumbbells, okay? And all you're gonna be simply be doing is pulling towards almost your hips. And you wanna make sure that the elbow is not gliding against your side, it's a little bit out because it's in more of upward rotation of that scap, right? So it's depressed. So when you pull in, yeah, you're retracting, of course, your traps are gonna work a little bit there as well. But at the same time, you're depressing and you're keeping your scap in that positioning of an upward rotation, okay? So that's one movement that you could be doing. A second movement you could be doing, if you're doing any body weight training, you do an inverted row, and you can do this on the Smith machine, you can do this on P-bars, you can do it pretty much anywhere and everywhere, even on chairs, but you put your feet on top of something. And now when you're pulling up, because of the positioning of it, you gotta think about those actions. You're depressing. As you're pulling in, you're really depressing and you're not focusing on other muscles in your back as much. Okay, so you have that movement. Now the third movement, this is one of my favorite movements in the entire world. All you're gonna be doing, as you can see on the screen, my entire shoulder is internally rotated completely. Okay, and so as I'm going up, I'm dragging almost like my thumb and the inside of my palm, or actually my palm, not the inside of my palm, all the way up the entire wall as much as I can. Now, because of the structure of your shoulder, obviously it's going to externally rotate at a certain point once you get it over your head, because the action of flexion of your shoulder, I'm not even gonna get into that. Just make sure that you're trying to stay internally rotated with that shoulder as much as possible, all the way up. Remember, it's upward rotation, so as you're going up, it's going upward, 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 upward. Your traps are pulling down. That's what it's doing, because it's at the top of your scap. So it pulls, pulls, pulls. So imagine your scaps, and you have a trap that's right here, your low trap. It's gonna pull, 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 pull. Your scap's gonna be going up, right? Or it's gonna be pushed, pulling down in depression. Some things to be very, very aware of, okay? So any movement that you're really doing that involves anything like that, it is going to work your lower trap. Pull-ups, of course, they're gonna work your lower trap, but also the positioning of your hand. If you're here, it's gonna work a little bit less than, let's say you're here and a little bit wider, right? Okay, so these are just things to keep in mind. So those are three movements I highly, highly suggest that you complete. Now, supersets, this is really fun. One of the supersets I love to do is going in that position, and I generally, the one where crisscross applesauce, and I have my thumbs down, as you see on the screen again, that specific movement I like to do second because it burns. So I start with face pulls, pronated face pulls, so make sure that you're holding it in a pronated position here. You use a rope, and you're pulling just straight down here. Great movement for your low traps as well, also your posterior delts. And right from there, I go into that wall movement, crisscross applesauce, and I feel it like crazy. Now, if you only wanna do body weight training, I highly suggest you put your feet up, you elevate your feet, and you grab onto a bar. Like I said, it could be a P bar, it could be like the P bars are dip bars, by the way, or you can do a Smith machine, whatever's best for you. And yeah, that's pretty much it to really work those traps. So to build that mid back, you have the exercises now, right? Well, what about volume? What about frequency? I suggest training them 3 times per week. Because remember, higher the frequency, more volume that you're doing, the more you're gonna get out of it, the more your muscles are gonna be working it. I mean, it's science, it's fucking science. So be very careful with that as well though, because you don't wanna overdo it. So when you are increasing the frequency to 3 times per day, you wanna make sure you have a heavier day, you have a lighter day, and you have a moderate day. You have a very intense volume day, you have a less intense volume day, and you have a moderate volume day. So, so, so important, especially if you're trying to build the physique that you want, like in entirety, okay? So that's what I'll tell you, and also rest periods. Highly suggest 90 seconds. I do that with all of my sets right now. If I have a deload week, I'm at 2 minutes. Because remember, to really build size, you're between the 1-minute and 2-minute mark. Even when you're deloading, you gotta understand, and if you don't know what a deload is, like you're letting go of some of the loads, the resistance, the whatever it is, either body weight or weight training, you can deload for both. And you're kind of just giving off the gas a little bit to make sure that you're not going the speed limit, right? And what this does, even with that, the amount of time that you're resting, the sets, the volume, all that stuff, it takes into account of your overall growth time and time again, okay? So make sure you're focusing on that as well. Deloads, make sure you're giving it your all during those movements. So that's pretty much it. Middle back, focus more on your low trap. If you do these movements, you're gonna be great. I suggest anywhere from 8 to 12 repetitions. It burns like crazy, all these movements, especially if you do time under tension. Time under tension is another great, great, great way to build some size and thickness in specific areas. This is going to be anywhere from 5 to 8 seconds down, or eccentrically, and then 5 to 8 seconds concentrically. And that's where a lot of people go wrong, is that they think, oh, well, time under tension is only one side of it. No, because it's the entire movement. Now, can you do one side of it? Of course. Is it effective? Of course. But full time under tension is 5 to 8 seconds each way, eccentric and concentric. And eccentric just means the lengthening of a muscle. Concentric just means shortening of a muscle. That's all it means, okay? So hopefully you enjoyed this video. Really quick info video. I wanted to make sure that you could grab something and implement it immediately. Remember all those movements. Do not forget about them. Very, very important. Body weight or weight training, you could do both. And yeah, hopefully you enjoyed. Comment down below. If you have not already, I would love to hear what your thoughts are about these type of videos that we've been producing. And then also Create You Nutrition, link is in the description to buy your Create You Greens. I'm super excited for this product. And then lastly, the podcast every Tuesday and Friday. We just love doing it. We love impacting people with the voice and different subjects and things that you might not have ever heard of before coming on and listening to it. We're on Spotify, we're on iTunes and all the other audio platforms. So thanks for tuning in for another video. I'm Brennan. My next show is October 5th, my first show. I just bit myself in my mouth. But yeah, I'm super excited. I'm getting super, super lean. Can't wait for you to join me. We'll talk soon. Peace. Better than to call back. I missed your call. I finally think I'm fine.